Hey, so welcome into the channel Sage Sensitive Healing Tarot. Thank you for being here, and I do hope you're doing well, wonderful soul. These are going to be general tarot card messages for the sign of Cancer. So welcome in, Cancerian, and thank you for being here. These are general messages, so all of the messages may not apply to all of you, Cancer. So take the ones that do apply and the rest let them fly. Thank you so much for hitting that like button, showing your support. By sharing the messages with those you love, you can hit the share button and feel free to share to your WhatsApp, Facebook, or blog. Also, you may subscribe to the channel if you have not done so. Welcome into the family. All of your support is truly appreciated. All right, now let's get into the messages for you, Cancer, and breathe in and let's get started. According to the cards, you're feeling a little bit sad or depressed or worried, anxious, bothered in thought, in mind, in feeling. And maybe something keeping you up at night. This could be about a soulmate connection. Maybe you're wondering about your soulmate, your twin flame with the 12 cups energy, or some union, a vow, a commitment. But you have justice on your side. Something will work out in your favor. It will work out. It will balance out for you. I feel like it is a love situation. Something that may have broken your heart or caused you sadness. Something you're living in the past. Okay? Maybe having to do with work or earth sign or fellow water sign or air sign, really. Maybe neglect. What is that? But you're leaving behind the 8 of Pentacles, which is working, dedicating yourself to work, material things, focusing on the material plane, really. Money, business, working alone, separating yourself. But really, and I feel it's really talking about money and working. You're like switching up your focus. Your highest achievement here is the Ace of Wands. So I do feel like you have something new coming in for you. A new idea, a new job, a new business, new land title, documents, deeds, a new family, new friend, new tribe with the Ace of Wands. Because the Wands energy is anything that has to do with earth, liberty, creation, the root of creation, fertility, reproduction, the continuation of life. That is even thoughts, feelings, ideas, anything that can be manifested. And that is what is happening so for you. And it could be coming as a gift from the divine. Okay, like I say, justice is on your side. So it's almost like the spiritual is working with you as well for whatever to balance out. Whatever you're worrying about is going to balance itself out. And I feel it's in your obstacle energy, your challenge is the 2 of Cups. So this could be about love, okay? And it has something to do with, really has something to do with a home. Because in all 3 cards, we see a home in the distance. So maybe someone is separating from a home or moving toward one. But I feel like your hope is getting a new.
CMOS heals the body by removing harmful chemicals that are caused by some foods we eat, hormones, toxic substances, and radiation from 5G from our devices. Heal your temple with the minerals of infinite oceans. CMOS has over 90 of the 102 nutrients our body needs, like copper, which creates balance and harmony. To learn more about CMOS health benefits or to order your first premium grade CMOS, email italkitchenstyle@gmail.com.
One with the Ace of Wands over this house here. Okay? And I feel like it is there for you with the justice energy. It's either a new house or a new love or a new family. Okay? New family perhaps. So maybe you're relocating, you're starting over, moving away from a house that was crowded or was too materially focused, you know, because you see this tall tree here. There's so many different pentacles on this tree, like everyone was claiming this tree or whatever this thing was that you're moving away from. And it's almost like you're going to be given your own roots. You may be relocating, like moving away from a business or a family business and really like going somewhere far and different to start over, set up your own life. So let's see what is to come in the future. We have the Two of Swords. For me, when I see Two of Swords, it speaks of intuition, being able to see even beyond the veil or through the veil with your senses, your internal senses. I feel like you're going to be really connected to your truth, your light, your soul, which is your intuition, your emotions, more balanced, more sharp-tongued, or more straightforward, asking for what you want, more clarity. I feel like you're going to get the clarity you need about what happened with the Two of Cups. Can you see the challenge is the Two of Cups, and you're in Swords energy. The outcome is Two of Swords with the Moon and Water energy. So it's all about emotions, focus, thoughts, staying true to your words, knowing who you are. When I see the Two of Swords, it's also knowing who you are internally, inside out, you know. You've aligned with the greatest force of love. So you accept that part of you. It helps you to build your stability, your faith, your trust in who you are, even without needing someone else there. So some of you are missing another person to connect with, or you're feeling like there's a lack of connection. I feel like it could be coming, it has something to do with you internally, how you connect with yourself. Okay, so I feel like you're trying to figure out how to really connect with even yourself so you can have more personal connections. But like I said, I keep looking back at the Justice card because I feel like everything is balancing out with the Justice here at the base of everything for you. Okay, and you see there is already balance with the challenges, the Two of Cups. And the outcome is the Two of Swords. Two of Swords is also my ninja energy, which speaks of flexibility. That makes me know you have the mind space to get through, even though it may be sad or hard right now. I feel you're going to pick yourself back up and get clarity to go through, to start over, start anew, and to see what is coming in for you. So currently you may be walking away, moving on from a situation that was probably depleting your energy. Justice is on your side. Once more, let me reiterate to just tell you that. Okay, so it may be a separation between a soulmate, okay? Or what you thought. It's almost like it is disappointing for you to move away from this person or situation because maybe there was real love here. It was a divine union. But it could be this justice is divine too, that it's causing a balance, a shift. Someone is walking away from this union. And it's hard. It's like unintertwining. It's physically painful as well as emotionally and psychologically. Really moving away from someone you invested your love into. Okay. But it's going to work out in your favor. So yeah, I feel like that's the energy you're in, moving forward, moving on, dreaming bigger, moving towards your vision, not giving up, you know, staying flexible in mind, knowing you have what it takes to move forward. You have experience in work, in building and creating your own business. You know what I mean? You have experience in making money. So I feel like you can take that and move forward to start something off your own with a new idea that's coming in, a new business idea. I feel like this reading could also be geared toward love. It could really turn out to be a love reading completely, but just take the messages as they apply to you. Oh my, in your home situation, I feel like there's also separation from people from your past. Moving past old beliefs. Yeah, I feel like it has a lot to do with your mind space. Beliefs, things you used to tell yourself, really separating from those things. And then those that want to keep you in that mind frame cannot be with you. So it may be hard because these people could be family. You know, but I feel like you could be an elect. could be a chosen one. You think differently, speak differently, act differently. You know what I mean? And it's hard for you to let go to move forward. So I feel like there's this big pull in your energy, and that's what's making you sad. Alright. The Empress. Okay. Is in your hopes position. So the Empress is, for me, when I see the Empress, I feel like she's really divinely connected to everything, to her core self. She's self-aware. She knows why she feels, how she feels. She knows the thoughts that she has, where they stem from. She can read someone else's, other people's thoughts and feelings as well. So she's like, she's detailed. She pays attention to detailed. She has access to some intricate and detailed information about people. She's a reader, I feel. So that's your energy, Empress. I feel like you feel relaxed in the Empress mode, like you're calculative, relaxed, looking at your other options. The Empress energy also feels like a goddess to me, like your spirit family, like something, an energy that surrounds you, like Felicity or the goddess of fertility, something that protects you. It is in par, on par with justice energy as well, because I feel like what you're going through is actually quite a lot, the separation and these energies that want, you need to move forward, but you don't know what, how to move forward, you know. And let's see what your outcome is. The King of Cups, beautiful. Okay. So for me, I feel like you're going to be making the right decision. There's movement here on the water. You're going to be moving with your heart, trusting in your emotions. You're going to be feeling secure in the decision that you make, because you're taking the time now to go through the pieces, to feel out what's going to be best for you, so you know how to move forward, okay? Also, the King of Cups energy, I feel like you're emotionally balanced, moving from the Nine of Swords energy, where you were a little bit distraught over a disconnection or a disunion, and you're getting the insight back to claim yourself. I feel like you're sitting on your throne here. You know, I feel like you achieve what you want. This is another person. This person looks like a person I saw on media, on social media. As if they're telling me this person will, the outcome is this person will be successful. They will have the seat. Justice, and justice is in balance. Imbalance here. There's a lot of changes and transformations taking place. Like, people are seeing that this change needs to take place. People are visualizing this as the outcome. This man or this spiritual person, this leader, healer, guide, as the head on the throne here. Even across communities, villages, on the oceans, ruling, you know what I mean? Calling the shots, emotionally balanced, and one that has a vision. I feel like justice has been telling me all along that this is victorious. So I don't know, Cancer, whatever you're going through, I feel like you're going to be victorious. You're going to be sitting on your throne, in your element, really moving with your heart space, having a vision and moving toward that vision, because it is something that you found in you. It is like you know yourself internally, inside out. I feel like you could be moving toward love, or this is a love moving toward you. Like I say, we could be looking at this alignment as if you feel like some soulmate energy is coming towards you. Okay. But it's like a lot of beautiful things taking place. So I just want to say, the basis of this reading is that whatever you're experiencing that is uncomfortable in thought, justice is on your side. It's all balancing out. Okay, whatever it is, look, you're coming out on top. This is brilliant, because you know who you are. Your ancestors are with you. You know how to make money, how to work. You have gifts and talents, and you've been putting in the internal work. And that's why you appear as the Empress even wherever you are. The most challenging thing I see is just walking away from connections, all right? And disconnecting. The bottom of the deck, we have the Ace of Pentacles, which is an inheritance. I think this is your vision, what you're moving toward. An inheritance, a blessing, traveling with the world energy behind that too. So beautiful things coming up for you, Cancer. And this is your next 7 days ahead messages. So what I would say is look forward to things working out for you. And you're going to be feeling better from inside out as you become emotionally stronger, more grounded, even through the sadness that you're experiencing. Look out for something new too, a new business idea, a new feeling, a new intuition, a new person, fire sign, water sign moving toward you. Also a separation, maybe someone moving on, okay? Friend, family, work. And I feel like all that is happening is coming, is some bringing something into balance for you with the Justice energy. The Sun. Abundance and success. Freedom. That's what Justice is. You're a child of the Most High. And all will work, all is working in your favor. You can be, do have everything and anything in this world you desire. So what is on your side is your ability to be childlike and to express yourself freely. Even the heartache, you're not alone. There's nothing new under the sun. And to ask for help, I know it is a come. You're protected. I feel like you're surrounded. You're guided. So don't feel... I would advise you, try to tap into the energies that are around you, that love you, look out for you, encourage you, inspire you, because it is here, forgiveness, all of that, justice. The sun energy is material, success, and abundance, in love, in finance, okay? So even if it is a relationship you're worried about, which is your soulmate, it's going to work out. Positively, if it is money, a job, a business, it's all working out. So I feel like you're walking away, or this separation, moving on, with the Five of Pentacles is happening for healing and restoration, for balance. Making a decision that something isn't serving you and you're doing what's right for you. And that alone is pouring into your soul. So wherever you are, you have to decide where would be best for me, for my well-being, my peace of mind, my healing. You know, and move toward that. And that is justice for you. Okay? I feel like, you know, your energy may have been just going in all different sort of places, not focusing on what you really came here to be and to do and to live and to express. And now you want to move forward. Maybe people want to keep you back. Maybe they want to say, no, don't go, because they see now that you have the power and the capability to move forward. You're really deciding now. Now they want to say, no, stay. But maybe this is the time that you really should make that ultimate decision for yourself, for your well-being, for your healing, to put yourself in a place where you know you're going to flourish. Okay, because if you're somewhere, you know you're not flourishing there, you're not doing justice to yourself. So when I feel you moving toward somewhere for yourself, somewhere better for you, or moving away from what's not serving you, that's justice. It's promising. You know, the sun and the star, that's amazing. It's beautiful, beautiful. So I feel like even in your future, beautiful things will be happening for you. You know, like you'll be releasing, coming into the new, you're going to be recognized. You're going to be meeting new people, beautiful new high vibrational connections. Your soul family. You could be walking away from a job or a personal relationship, an open relationship that wasn't really serving you. Maybe someone you worked with, someone you're really, really attracted to, fire sign, someone who's very mystical and emotional and knows really how to get into your emotions, especially when it comes to sex, you know, and kissing and romance, all those things. They know how to get into you under your skin. So I feel like it's difficult to separate from, especially this person is a huge force in your life. Like, this person or situation represented with the King of Wands could be the majority reason why you're hesitating moving on. Could be a comfort zone as well. Anything that makes you feel too comfortable, but at the same time, you know, it's not, you're not flourishing, it's not the best for you, you know. Two of Swords is clarified by the Ace of Swords. I like that so much for your outcome. Because once you felt powerless, like a victim of circumstances, maybe here, a little bit out of control, and now look at you. Like I say, you're the ninja with the Two of Swords, flexible. You have the word. No, you have the entire sword. You don't have nine swords. Whether this was betrayal, whatever it was you were going through. No, I feel like you feel empowered with this powerful force. A higher consciousness. I say sometimes depression can be a magical thing. Because sometimes when you go down there in depression, you come back with magic. It's like you go in depression to collect magical information that you can now share with others, how to heal, etc. So I feel like that's what you're coming with. You're a survivor. You've gone through a lot, but you come up with this sword, with the lesson that you've learned through the situation. And that's what makes you flexible in mind, in thought, in emotion, and very skillful. And that is what's making you successful. And that is what's bringing the justice energy for you in love and everything. I feel like you're going to experience a new taste, a new flavor, but it's a new taste and it feels sweet. It could be love with the lover's energy, but maybe you're going to taste something because you're not seeing it or feeling it or touching it, but you're tasting, you know, the lover's. I don't know. Lovers is twin flame, soulmate energy, divine union, person you may have children with, fertility, procreate. Okay? Make love. So maybe that's what's coming in. A new love, your soulmate coming in. A new life. You're also getting a message, and it's going to be beautiful. I like it. You're getting a message for water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, or this is an emotional, spiritual message that's bringing in some kind of balance and good feelings to you. I like it. I don't even want to decipher it. And I just let the feelings sit here, but it's a beautiful message. Could be about money, multiplication of your income, just good feelings, gains, prosperity, really a change of life, really things working out for you. Remember, you're moving from the Five of Pentacles all the way to the Ten. I feel like double, something may double for you, like double income or double your money or double the good feelings, you know that when I see the Five of Pentacles and then the Ten of Pentacles, I get the feeling of, you know, that feeling, that scene in Matrix where Neo and Morpheus are walking down the street. This is the scene with the lady in the red dress. And he thought it was a real scene until Morpheus froze the scene and showed him that, or revealed to him that the lady in the red dress was like literally a temptation. You know that there's a movie where it's called Jumper, where this person is able to jump from one place to the other, different times, different realities. Okay. I feel like that is the magic here with the Five of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles. It's transformation. Like being able to jump reality. It's telling me how you're going to, how things are changing for you. Because in this card, we see two people looking like, you know, they're both, they're not feeling good. Not, they're low on energy. And then in the 10, it's like double everything here. 5-5 is 10. Two people looking good here. Lady in red once more. And there's a witness here. I think that could be relating to the church in the 5. Here, the witness, the religion, or the seer. And it's not just that it's a hope. It's the hope in it. It's like the energy of someone who believes in Santa Claus, and then come to find out Santa Claus is real, you know. But this person never really sees Santa Claus. They just always believe in it. So it's all about belief and hope, and it's almost like it makes it real. I went somewhere with that reading, with that message, but I hope it makes sense to you and inspires you some way, shape, or form. Okay. You may be getting proposed to. For some of you, this is a business proposal or love. You may be receiving something of complete, ultimate abundance. You know, that's what your obstacle is. Maybe the person coming into you, you're wondering why they're not, or money that was supposed to come into you, or just your feelings of abundance, your ultimate, supreme abundance. Just you always feeling good. You're wondering why it's not coming through. That was your obstacle. But I feel like you're realizing now that the power is within you. As I say with the sword, it's a higher consciousness. You figured something out about your wealth. That's why you're moving from the Five of Pentacles all the way to the 10. It's like magic. You know what I'm saying? Like with depression, you go down there to collect something. So you're going through something, but it's like you're going to work on some with the Eight of Pentacles. You're working, creating, and building this, like, this just kingdom for yourself of wealth, feelings of well-being. This empire, I feel you're going to be creating huge things, Cancerian, you know. I feel like you're dreaming big and you have great visions that you're going to see through. You need the strength and the encouragement to get you through this spiritually, okay, emotionally, so that you can take the necessary actions and you can listen to your intuitions keenly. And that's why you go down to the darkness sometimes and in the sad spaces. So that you can be more discerning of what you want and the steps that you really need to take. Because sometimes we make mistakes, you know. It's really only for you to know better where you need to go. Like, oh, and I can step there next time I go here. Okay, so know that you have the power within you to be, to have everything and anything you want in this world. All right, so let's look at the Empress. Oh my, the Wheel of Fortune and the Ace of Cups wanted to come through too. So the Empress is talking about the Wheel of Fortune. Like I was saying, I feel like the Empress has connection to her innate self. She is very self-aware. The Wheel of Fortune is saying there are a lot of blessings coming in for you here. Also, it's talking about a compass energy. Knowing how to follow your true intuition as the Empress. And I feel like that's what leads you to the outcome as the King of Cups. I think this is telling me about what it is. Because the King of Cups is a spiritual person. And then the devil, I feel the devil and the hermit accidentally came out. You know, like it's two vibrations that just wanted to. It feels like plastic. You know what I mean? It's like a piece of poly bag. That's how the energy came out. And it came out among quality. You know, it's like showing up to an event where the caliber is different. You know, you're plastic and you're coming out amongst almond leaves. That's how the devil and the hermit came out. Like, they still wanted to be relevant. It's the energy of these people dressing up to go to presidential parties, even though they weren't invited. Just to feel included. I just had to say that with the devil and the hermit card, because that's how I feel. But I do feel like the King of Cups, this is what you're dealing with spiritually, because you're very focused here. In your mission, you're visualizing, like, what do I need to do? What work can I do here? You're still in Empress mode and King of Cups mode. How can I heal this planet? How can I heal? Because as a King of Cups and Empress, that's what you think about. Healing, restoration, especially with the Star card and the Sun energy that we saw earlier. That's your mission. To find answers or to seek, or something with the devil having to do with attachments and fears. Okay, so you don't have any fear, because I feel like you're here to, you have the strength with the Ace of Swords. The Ace of Swords, that is the word of God, the Bible, the sword, the tongue. Remember, I said justice is on your side. That's why this is such a powerful reading for you, because you're here to really bring light and truth to what we classify as the devil energy, or maybe to even give a new perspective on it. Something, I don't know, maybe you're going to be writing, creating a business surrounding healing, surrounding isolation, surrounding fear. Okay, my darling, beautiful soul, my wonderful, amazing, vibrant soul. Okay, so justice is on your side. Much love to you. This is your reading. I'll leave it here for you. If you found any messages of inspiration, let me know by liking the video, sharing it with those you love. I really do appreciate your efforts to support. So hit the like button, hit the share button, share to your groups, your social media, Facebook groups, WhatsApp, and your blogs. I really appreciate the efforts that you put into the support. Thank you for being a part of Sage Sunset Healing Tarot. I love you for being here. Much love. And I'll see you next time. Remember that you can be, to have everything and anything in this world you desire, because you're all, and all is within you. Now go out there and do what you're meant to do. Much love. You're not alone. You're not alone. Bye.